Welcome to Superior Profit Weekly Market Roundup, 13th January 2018. I am Sagar Nandi, Chief Analyst and Trader at Superior Profit, based in Singapore. I will not take time to introduce myself. If you are interested to know more about me, the company, and more importantly, how it can help in your trading, you may visit the website superiorprofit.co and click on the About menu. Before we begin, we go through the standard disclaimer. This demonstration is for educational purposes only. It is designed to share information on Superior Profit's trading system. The information presented here should only be used by people who are aware of the risk inherent in trading. Past performance is no guarantee of future return. Superior Profit is not an investment advisor. This session is not for any recommendation of buying or selling stock or any other instrument. Superior Profit will have no liability for any investment decision made by its audience. As in the other roundups, we look at key commodities that impact related stocks. We look at oil and gold through technical charts. When the broad market goes up, it tends to take many stocks along with it. Not all, but many stocks. To know where the broad market is heading, we study the market breadth using NYSE and NASDAQ internals, and also look at the broad market ETFs using technical charts. Understanding industry rotation and strength of the industries adds additional edges to the trades. We will study that using industry scorecard and heat map in QH. Along the way, we may review some of the examples from Q Forum and certainly look for potential trades for the coming week. That was the last slide of the presentation. Let's move to live system. This is another week when everything that we analyze regularly went up. That is US oil, gold, and also the broad market ETFs. We start our commodities technical analysis with US oil, the oil ETF. We are analyzing it with weekly backdrop chart and daily hop-on chart. Weekly chart shows that oil went up strongly for three successive weeks. This week, the gain was even more than two previous weeks. We can see that from the large bullish hollow candle. It is much above the upper boundary in weekly chart, and also above the upper boundary in the daily chart. Because it is overextended, we are not going to chase it right now. If oil pulls back a little bit and resumes its uptrend, it may give us a low risk trend following long opportunity. Weekly chart shows that gold also went up this way. It has a lower tail showing it tried to go down in the beginning but then recovered strongly and closed at the high of the week. Its gain this week was bigger than previous week's gain. In daily chart, gold is much above the upper boundary line. On this yellow candle, this week it did give a swing low. However, even that swing low was above upper boundary. So probably we would not like to take any long trade at that point. At the right edge, it is even more extended to the upside. So we will not be chasing it following Q guidelines and wait patiently for a better low-risk opportunity to come. After studying the two commodities, we start with market breadth analysis. We are using NASDAQ Composite Index and NYSE Composite Index along with three pairs of internals, new high-low, advanced decline, and up-down volume to study market breadth. As this analysis is using composite indices and weekly charts, it is to be used for longer term investment decisions, not for swing trading and certainly not for day trading. Weekly chart shows NASDAQ and NYSE both went up. Last week I mentioned that the uptrend strengthened for both the indices, and this week it got even stronger. There is no sign of weakness in any of these two indices. New high low for both NASDAQ and NYSE strongly went up. For a long time, this internal new high low had been stronger than the other internals, and it got even more bullish this week. For both NASDAQ and NYSE, it crossed above the trend line connecting earlier peaks, and it is approaching the previous peaks that were meant. If these two indices go up for 1 week more or maybe 2 weeks more, it seems new high low will surpass clearly earlier peaks. The other two internals, advanced decline and up down volume, they are not so near to surpassing previous peaks. However, they are also strong. Out of the six internals, all six closed in the positive, and four, shown by the cyan color, went up this week. Two declined, but all closed above zero. From this broad market breadth study, we can conclude that the indices are clearly bullish. The internals got stronger this week. Relative to longer term values, we can't say it is weak anymore. We may say it is neutral. And for this specific week, it is clearly strong. This shows the market is strong and it strengthened from the first week of the year. Let us see if the market ETFs supports the same conclusion. In weekly chart, SPY went up strongly for the second successive week in this new year. It is far above weekly boundary line, and it is above the daily upper boundary line as well. It is overextended, so we are not going to take any long trade right now. Usually we don't like to chase the market. We may wait for it to pull back and then go up again, giving us a low risk trend following long opportunity. QQQ, this also went up in the weekly chart. It's above upper boundary. And just like in case of SPY, this is above upper boundary in the daily chart as well. There is no low risk entry point right now. DIA also went up strongly. It has high activity for two successive weeks. This is very similar to SPY. In the beginning of this year, that is the last 2 weeks, DIA has been the strongest of the four broad market ETFs. Again, here it is above upper boundary both in daily and weekly, and there is no low risk entry right now. All of these three ETFs, SPY, QQQ and DIA, made all-time highs. They were already in uptrend and the uptrend became stronger. IWM Russell 2000 ETF is the only ETF where the uptrend was not clear. I discussed in previous roundup that though the lows were going up, supported by memory support line, the highs were at approximately the same level. It was inside a kind of triangle pattern. It could not make new all-time high last week, though the other three ETFs could do that. This week, IWM also broke out of that high and made a new all-time high. It has a very strongly bullish candle in weekly chart, just like all the other ETFs. It is still lagging the other ETFs, shown by the relative performance line tilting downward. However, there is no sign of any bearish trade in IWM, and it is overextended, it just broke out. So there is no low risk entry point on the long side as well. From the broad market ETF study, we see that market is very strong. Though there are many people who are thinking of a possible pullback, Q traders finally trade based on what is actually happening. And the actual picture, both in terms of market breadth as well as these ETFs, show that market is strong and getting stronger. In this scenario, it may be safer to stay away from trying any short trade. We now move to sector industry analysis, and you will see that the market's strength is reflected there as well. Every week, we study 11 economic sectors across three review periods. Red bar represents performance of this week, green bar performance of 1 week before the red bar, and blue bar performance of 2 weeks before the green bar. Together, they give us 4 weeks or about 1 month of performance. Any bar coming to the right of the zero line indicates the sector went up, and a bar going to the left of the line shows the sector went down. 7 of the 11 sectors gained. Flip-flop that was prevalent in the previous week was mostly absent. All the 7 gaining sectors continued their up move from the week before. And 3 of the losing sectors also continued their decline from the previous week. The sector movement is clearly bullish. 3 sectors gained by more than 3%. That is pretty large gain considering the fact that market is already at all-time high. Industrials, energy, and consumer discretionary. Consumer discretionary industries went up sharply. We'll study that during industry analysis. Utilities, telecom, and real estate declined last week, and the decline continued. They lost between 2 to 3.5% this week. Consumer staples is the only sector that flip-flopped. That was a gainer 1 week ago. The green bar came to the right of the zero line and it lost this week. As 10 of the 11 sectors continued their direction from the previous week, it was probably easier to take new trend following trades or hold on to existing ones and make a nice profit. In the last roundup, I mentioned because of the flip-flop that was obvious, it was not easy to take trend following trades. But for last 2 weeks, that is last week and this week, markets are moving in the same direction. 10 of the 11 sectors did that. So it was easier to take trend following trades during these 2 weeks. This uniformity in trend will be clearer in the industry studies as well. We are looking at the best performing industries, 10 best performing industries. 5 of them are in consumer discretionary sector, probably reflecting the confidence of people to spend more money. It could be the result of better employment prospect. Unemployment is coming down in the USA. Rising wages. Some companies declared rise in wages, rise in minimum wages at least, as well as possible tax savings from the new tax laws. Other than airline and advertising, all the other industries continued their upward momentum from the previous week. Therefore, at the industry level also, we see the continued momentum in the bullish direction. Let's flip-flop. Previous roundups discussed the possibility of long trades in marine industry. This industry gained by a large percentage this week, 8%. Matson went up by 7.5% after giving a trend following go with flow long trade on Monday, 8 Jan. This stock has good valuation in QVITA. So we had large moves in Kirby Corp, KEX, and Matson Inc, MATX.N. Cispan SSW didn't move yet. However, it is optimally valued. It is very near memory resistance. If the industry continues to be stronger, then there is high likelihood that Cispan will also break above. Let's study marine industry from QH, drill down and look at these stocks. Every time we open QH, it analyzes the 11 sectors and more than 170 industries across 12 monthly review periods and more frequently over recent periods from 10 days up to 1 day period. 1 day period being calculated in real time. It assigns a large number to the best performing item, assigns cyan color. Number 1 score to the worst performing item and magenta color, and applies a heat map color gradient to all the items in between. We can go to industry analysis and filter for marine industry. Instantly from the heat map, we can see that it was weak earlier, magenta, and gradually turning cyan. This is a beautiful pattern, very smooth transition from magenta to cyan, not flip-flopping between the two colors, that gives us opportunities to take easy trend following or trend reversing trades. Trend reversing trades might have come when it transitioned between magenta and cyan some time ago. Now probably there will be more trend following or momentum trading. We can drill down by clicking the get stocks button. It goes to Thomson Reuters and retrieves the stocks. Then we can click the calculator to retrieve data about the stocks and calculate vital statistics. We can instantly see from the color coding that several of the stocks are still optimally valued. C-SPAN is one of them. MATX is also one of them. Earlier, when we studied this industry in market roundups, KEX was also optimally valued, but now it has gone up, so it is not optimally valued anymore. This is very useful visual cue. We can take the trade in a stock like KEX when it is optimally valued and hold on to it. Keep an eye on the chart, but also keep an eye on the scorecard. When the scorecard turns yellow, we know that it is not optimally valued anymore, but it still has potential to go up. When it turns magenta in this scorecard, then we are more cautious. We may be observing it more closely and make sure that protective stop is in place. It is not overvalued yet, so there is high chance that it will continue to go up. Let's look at these three stocks using Q charts. KEX, MATX and SSW. In weekly chart, Kirby Corp is going up for 4 weeks with cyan backdrop candle color. The cyan backdrop candle color is bullish. In daily chart, in this area, it created higher high and then it created a higher low. Therefore, the cyan candle in daily chart gave us a rule following go with flow long trade setup. Using fine-tuned real-time chart, we could take the long trade somewhere in the lower half of the candle. We didn't have to wait for the close of the day. We could do that because the stock was nicely valued in terms of fundamental and the industry was also strong. It easily hit upper boundary and is far above that now. Swing traders could book partial profit. As the stock is very strong, industry is also strong, there would be no reason to exit full position. Instead, protective stop could be used using Q protection signal. Let's see where is the trailing stop now as per protection signal. Long position protection signal is decided by this magenta series of dots. Our entry price was at this level if we took the trade at closing price of the day, or it could be at a lower price if we were using fine-tuned real-time chart. At the time of entry, the stock could be at this level just below recent low, this magenta dot level. As the stock went up, the magenta dots also went up. As of Friday's close, the magenta dot has come up to the upper boundary. So if we are using trailing stop, we could put trailing stop at this level, which is already far above the entry price level. Even if the position was to stop out in the coming week, it will give us a profit that is higher than the risk taken in the trade. Looking at the industry and the stock strength, it seems more likely that it will go up than it will go down. Still, following discipline, there is no harm in putting a trailing stop on this stock. KEX gave us an easy trend following long trade. MATX, Matson Incorporation, also gave us an easy, again trend following, go with flow long trade on this cyan candle. Cyan candles in a stock that is in uptrend with higher high and higher low represents an optimal long entry point with low risk. This will be the entry price. Stop will be just below recent low and profit could be booked once the risk distance is covered or at the upper bounded. By Friday, it has hit the profit target and again partial profit could be booked. The weekly candle is very bullish. Industry remains strong. Probably there will not be any reason to exit whole position. Partial position could be held with protective stop. MATX is still optimally valued. The other stock that is optimally valued is C-SPAN. In the daily chart, C-SPAN was moving in a narrow sideways range. It broke out of that strongly. Then it is consolidating sideways, or you may say gradually going up. It has a memory resistance in daily chart. It is there also in the weekly chart. The weekly candles are bullish for 4 successive weeks. Daily chart is also in uptrend. If the industry strength continues, it is more likely that this stock will break out of the memory resistance and continue to go up. Those who were alert could probably take a long position on this cyan candle. Though it was very close to the upper boundary, the closing was actually above the upper boundary, it would not be a standard go with flow trade setup. One could take it only if one was studying the industry as well as this stock regularly and was aware of the industry strength as well as this stock's fundamental strength. Marine industry shows that if we use QH, industry rotation insight, we are able to take timely trades both in the long direction and short direction with more confidence. Department store is a big winner this week, going up by more than 12%. Many people thought departmental stores would perish in competition with Amazon. Amazon is doing very well. However, that doesn't mean we couldn't take profitable trades in department stores. Several of them went up strongly, beginning from about 7 to 8 months ago till about 1 month ago and again this week. Using QH, the industry heat map, you could have very profitable investments, even long-term investments, not only swing trades, in these stocks, showing that it pays to believe what we see, the industry rotation through the heat map, and trade based on that. Not just take long trades in Amazon. In fact, because stocks in this industry were languishing for a long time, when they started to go up, they went up sharply. And there were many highly profitable trades. Let's study this industry in a bit more detail. Looking at QH industry heat map, we can immediately see that somewhere between about 9 month and 8 month period, department stores started to gain strength and since then continuing to hold on to strength. This week it is again one of the best performers. We can drill down to look at the stocks. It is retrieving the stocks from Thomson Reuters. Clicking the calculator button will retrieve data on these 6 stocks and calculate the vital statistics. It calculates a lot of other insights as well. Mostly the vital statistics are enough to make an investment decision. However, we can look at the other data as well. From the vital statistics color coding, instantly we can see that even now several stocks are optimally valued. We know that from the cyan color on the relative value score. These are MESIS, M, KSS, Kohl's and JCPenney. If we go to the detail panes in the vital statistics tab, we can see that Dillard's DDS gained over 8 months by 49%, over 3 months by 35%. JCPenney, over 1 month it gained by 41%, over 10 days by 23%. In this pane, the green colors highlight the best performer in each period. So we can immediately decide over each of these study periods which stock was performing best. So we can see JCPenney performed best over 1 month period as well as 10 days period. Nordstrom gained by 29% over 2 months. Kohl's 50% over 3 months. These are significant gains. Amazon is also strong, but it's a very large company. It is unlikely that Amazon will gain by 50%. May happen, but unlikely. Whereas the stocks here, which were optimally valued, they gained very sizably. And looking at the industry heat map, we could start to look for potential opportunities and take them at the right time, low risk entry point on Q charts. This is a graph of the department store stocks percentage gain in this week. Sears Holding gained by 3.4%, Nordstrom 7.4%, Macy's 9.8%, JCPenney 12.2%, Kohl's 17.5%, and Dillard's 20%. Very large gains. Using QED, you could catch profitable entry points in all these stocks. Let's look at Dillard's. You will see that the bullish headwind, the reversal signal in Q charts, beautifully caught the very low in the weekly chart at the end of March. Another example why we take the headwind signal seriously. That was in Dillard's. And in Macy's, you could buy it at the very low again around mid-October using the same bullish headwind signal and false breakout signal, also in weekly charts. And Nordstrom gave a profitable trend following setup even in this week. It was on Wednesday, 10th January. Let's look at JWN. Nordstrom first and then look at Macy's and Dillard's to see how we could buy these stocks at an optimal buy point. In case of Nordstrom on daily charts and in case of Macy's and Dillard's on weekly charts for longer term investment. Nordstrom is having cyan, that is bullish backdrop color candle, for many weeks now. In fact, after the last earnings, which was positive and which was better than the previous earnings, it never went down. It is continuing to go up. In daily chart, it was going up and on this candle, Wednesday, it gave us a cyan color candle. That is the signal for taking low risk buy trade. Entry could be at the close of the day, profit target would be upper boundary, which was already hit on Friday. This trade came when the industry was strong, so we will be more confident to take the trade. Interestingly, there was a bullish headwind at this point. This caught the very low of the stock. Since then, it continued to go up. There was earnings just after the bullish headwind came, so we'll probably not buy the stock on the bullish headwind. Instead, wait for the earnings to be over. Price slightly tilted down, very slightly, and gave us a cyan color candle. The industry was strong at that time also, so one could take a long trade on this day or on the next day and hold on to the trade using the earnings insight. Using the headwind, we could catch the stock just as it was starting to go up from the very bottom. We could do the same thing in Macy's and Dillard's also. In case of Macy's, we had a bullish headwind signal in the weekly chart somewhere in late August. It went up for several weeks and then tried to go below the watermark that was created by the bullish headwind candle. Then there was earnings week and it reversed, closed above the support level, thereby creating a false downside breakout. It was accompanied by extremely high activity. This allowed us to take a sideways market box long trade just after earnings at the very low, and since then price has gone up. For last couple of weeks it is moving sideways, probably consolidating. However, we have already made considerable profit from the entry point. We may still hold partial position, especially for long-term investors, and see if profit continues to run. Again, the bullish headwind could alert us to potential reversal and we could take the trade almost at the very bottom. Similarly, in Dillard's also, a bullish headwind came in the weekly chart somewhere in April last year, and that has caught the very bottom of the stock. The stock could never go below that level. It went up for several weeks. In the earnings week, it had a big drop but stopped right at the watermark level created by the bullish headwind candle. I have mentioned several times earlier, after bullish headwind, if a stock goes up, then if it happens to come back to the same level, some buying may still be left. In fact, it reversed immediately the very next week. You could take it as a kind of bounce long trade setup on weekly chart. Because the stock was fundamentally optimally valued at that time, you could take it as long-term investment as well. This week, it in fact gave a cyan color candle on this day. If somebody was watching the stock and tracking the stock regularly, they might take a long trade. Though strictly speaking, it was not a go with flow long trade setup because it was not in clear uptrend. It was in a sideways market. Because it was in a sideways market, the appropriate setup will be box long trade setup. The watermark levels in DDS daily chart shows that it was moving in a sideways range. when price came to this level and reversed, giving a bull release signal. This cyan star or green star, it showed that there is a possible box long trade, and it was preceded by heavy activity that met all the conditions except that the candle color was still bearish, that is red. When that happens, we may not take the long trade immediately at market close of this day, but wait for market open on the next day and take the long trade. I can see there was also a memory resistance line. Therefore, we might not take the long trade even on this candle, because there was a memory resistance very close. In fact, this day tried to close above the memory resistance but pulled back, closed just below it. However, the very next day it was clearly bullish, both in shape and color. So it took a while for the candle color to turn to green, took one more day, and because of the memory resistance, we had to wait for another day. So if we were taking a long trade, we'll be taking it on the cyan color candle at the close of the day. Stop will be below recent low. This will be our risk distance. Because it was in a sideways market, our profit target will be previous peak. That was slightly less than the risk in the trade. It is probably okay to take such a slightly lower reward trade looking at the strength of the industry. Now it has broken out of the range. Now it is also near a weekly memory resistance. Looking at that memory resistance, somebody would surely book at least partial profit on Friday. That is, the entry price was at this level and certainly some profit will be booked on Friday. If it breaks out of the memory resistance, it will probably go higher. And that will happen if the industry continues to strengthen. We saw that in department stores, not by listening to other people but believing what we see in industry rotation heat map and drilling down to identify fundamentally strong stocks, we could take very profitable trades. And we may be still holding some of them, trying to let profit run. Worst performing industries. 7 of the worst performing industries are in real estate, and they are weak for a long time. Rates dominate the languishing industries: healthcare rates, residential rates, specialized rates, equity real estate investment trust, office rates, retail rates, diversified rates. All the rates are languishing. However, they are languishing for a long time. Therefore, we are probably not going to look for short trades in them. Instead, start to watch out for potential reversal. And that potential reversal will show up in the acceleration score before it is known to others. Currently, there is no such bullish acceleration signal in the rates, but we can keep an eye on them. We saw that when everybody was thinking department stores will not go up, we could catch the turning point using QH and Q charts. Sooner or later, the rates are going to be in the same situation. When everybody thinks it is not going to go up, we'll see the acceleration in QH heat map and we'll see some bullish signal in the rates charts as well. And we'll be waiting for that. Right now it is not there and it is too late to take any short trade. So we may step aside for now. the acceleration is very useful, and that is actually visible now in alternative carriers. In that industry, century link is optimally valued. Again, bullish headwind caught the very low of this stock, both in weekly and daily around December, month of December in 2017. At that time, I analyzed CTL in market roundups, and we could take very profitable swing as well as long-term investments based on that. After initial gain, CTL is nicely holding on to the gain and consolidating. Little bit sideways range right now. It has acceleration in the industry. It is probably likely that the stock will break out upward. Let's have a look at the industry in QH. See the acceleration, drill down, identify CTL, and finally look at its technical charts. Alternative carriers industry, it has turned somewhat cyan on score 5 days period, that is the primary period for evaluating strength, both for long-term investment entry as well as swing trading. More telltale signal is in the acceleration base score over primary period. It is clearly cyan. We could drill down. It is retrieving data for the stocks of this industry, alternative carriers. It has found multiple stocks, and we can click the calculator button to retrieve data of these stocks and calculate vital statistics. Calculation is complete. Instantly, we can see CTL, CenturyLink, is the best value stock. I had discussed it several times earlier. It pays a very nice dividend. Initially, when I started discussing it, the dividend yield percentage was more than 14%. As the stock has gone up somewhat, the dividend yield percent has lowered, but still a very beautiful 12.4%. Let's look at the stock. CenturyLink displayed a bullish headwind in the weekly chart on this candle, and in the same week it displayed bullish headwind in the daily chart. One could take a long trade right at the very bottom, or if you wanted to wait for the first trend following long signal that came on this cyan colored candle, when it dipped a little bit, made a swing low and went up again. So one could take the long trade, trend following long trade, confidently on this cyan color candle. Initial profit target was hit quickly, and now it is consolidating sideways. In the weekly chart, we have a bullish shaped candle. Tried to go down a little bit here, but close near the high of the week. And in the weekly chart, it has closed above the memory resistance line. Looking at the chart, it seems more likely that the stock will go up from here. It is moving in narrow sideways range, and the range being narrow, one could try to take a breakout trade. I usually don't take breakout trades unless the breakout allows me to have a low risk trade, that is the stock should be nearby. Because the range is narrow, here that is possible. I'll be happier to take such a trade if the industry is also strengthening, accelerating, or it is already strong, as shown by the score over 5 days period. You may keep an eye on this too. Other than the best and worst performers, we also study the accelerating industries. They often tend to be best performers in subsequent weeks. Consumer discretionary sector is dominant again. 7 of the accelerating industries are in this sector. Broadcasting, leisure facilities, hotel, resorts, cruise lines, advertising, casinos and gaming, consumer electronics, household appliances. advertising industry accelerated and also turned bullish over primary 5 days period in QH. So you may keep an eye on stocks of this industry. Let's have a look at this industry, drill down and look at the stocks. For finding the accelerating industries, we can go to industry analysis tab, sorted by pace column, largest to smallest. And we can see advertising industry here. It was magenta earlier and nicely turning into cyan. Primary 5 days period score is bullish and 5 days period acceleration is also bullish. We can know that instantly from the cyan color. And it is holding on to the strength over 2 days and 1 day period. Let's drill down, retrieving the stocks. This drilling down from industry to stocks, identify fundamentally strong stocks and looking for buy point on technical charts gives very high confidence on taking the trades. And the profit potential is also substantially higher than just using fundamental analysis or just using technical analysis. We see several stocks are still optimally valued. Let's look at the top two, IPG and OMC. They are nicely valued both in relative valuation as well as internal valuation. Cyan color in both these parameters. Let's have a look at Q charts for IPG and OMC. Interpub Group. Again, a beautiful example of how the bullish headwind in the weekly chart as well as in the daily chart got the very low. Somewhere in November last year, got the very low, and since then the stock has nicely gone up. We could try to take a bullish headwind trade on this candle, except that the candle had long upper tail. So we'll stay away from taking any long trade at that time, following our discipline. We'll confidently take the long trade either on this cyan candle or on this cyan candle. Both will be very profitable. It gained, consolidated, and then moved up further. Again, the bullish headwinds were very useful. And the cyan color candles, which gave us optimal trend following long opportunity points. OMC, Omnicom Group. Again, surprisingly, here also the bullish headwind in the weekly and daily got the very low. When the bullish headwind came in daily, the daily candle was indecisive, so we were not going to risk money taking a long on that candle. Our first low risk entry point would be this cyan color candle. That gave substantial profit, consolidated, actually tilted down little bit and went up again. In both of these two stocks, there was bullish headwind signals that helped us catch the very bottom. In fact, when these headwind signals came, the industry was also accelerating. How I saw that? That was around November, right? Let's filter out the other industries. I saw that about 2 months ago, it turned from magenta to cyan. This is monthly period. So I thought that when it was changing from magenta to cyan over monthly period, probably it gave bullish signal over weekly period in one of the market roundups. So I brought up the earlier weekly market roundups from YouTube, and indeed I noticed that in the 11th November market roundup, advertising was accelerating. That is the same time that we had the bullish headwind signals in these two stocks. In this way, The acceleration signal over 5 days helped us gain confidence in taking the long trade. From the industry standpoint, Q vital scores are still bullish, so certainly they were bullish, that is optimally valued at that time. And in technical charts, they had bullish signal in terms of bullish headwind and followed by cyan color flow candle. So we had all the signals coming together at that time and we could take the trades confidently. Again, we could choose almost the very low of these stocks. Same thing we could do in departmental stores. Same thing we could do in case of alternative carrier stock, CenturyLink. And probably we are doing that right now for marine industries. It therefore is very, very possible, I think almost certain, that we will be able to do the same in rates as well as it starts to turn around. Lastly, we look at the decelerating industries. They tend to be worst performer in subsequent weeks. However, this period is not usual period. The market is very strong. I will probably stay away from taking short trades. Instead, sometimes poor performing industries as well as decelerating industries give us buy the dip opportunities, and we can infer that by using the Q edge and Q charts together. Last week, if you remember the market roundup, you could see that from YouTube channel also. Auto industries were best performers, and this week 4 auto industries decelerated. Automobile manufacturers, automobiles, automotive retail, and auto parts and equipment. 3 are common on both the lists. So 3 were best performer last week but decelerated this week. But deceleration doesn't mean that they turn negative. Though decelerated, all the industries actually gained. Not gained so much as in the previous week. That could give us buy the dip opportunity. Auto parts and equipment decelerated over this week, however, regained score rapidly on Thursday and Friday. We'll look it up on QA. And this stock, American Axle, went up nicely after giving a trend following go with flow long setup on 2nd January. The same way when the industry was among best performers. Again, an easy trade that we could take by combining industry insight from QH with technical charts from Q Global or Q Elite. Let's look at the decelerating industries by sorting on the pace column. Smallest to largest values, we have the decelerating industries. These are decelerating because they lost score rapidly from 10 days period to 5 days period. Auto parts and equipment is one that decelerated. We know that from the magenta color. We just need to look at the color, magenta color over pace 5 days period. That's the primary period. However, we see it nicely regained score, turned cyan over 2 days and 1 day period. That also showed up as acceleration, cyan color, bullish acceleration over 2 days period. That caught my attention and I drilled down into the stocks. It's retrieving data from Thomson Reuters. Extremely reliable data and made very nice use of using QH and QVITA. Everything is visual. We can infer insights in minutes, if not seconds, as we are doing right now. By the way, over Thursday, 11th January, I had a live webinar session that was arranged by MetaStock. The video is already available in our YouTube channel. You can also go to the education center and video pay and find that recording under 360 degrees analysis. If you have downloaded the QSight 360 degree app, you can also watch it from the spotlight section in the app. Let's come back to QEdge. Instantly from color coding, we can see American Excel AXL is optimally valued both for relative valuation score and internal valuation score. Just looking at cyan color is enough. So we could look up the chart. In the weekly chart, it has bullish color candle for 2 weeks now. In the daily chart, it made a lower low, went up, pulled back little bit, went up again, pulled back little bit, came to the memory support line and gave us a cyan color candle. This was, I think, on 2nd January. It already had higher high and higher low. Therefore, the cyan color candle would be the trigger for taking a trend following long trade. Going flow setup, could enter it at the close of the day, stop just below recent low, we'll book profit, at least partial profit at the upper boundary. It pulled down a little bit but went up again. As the stock is strong, the weekly candle color and shape both are strong, we may continue to hold on to partial position and try to let profit run. The next target could be around 20 when it will hit the memory resistance lines both in weekly and daily. If you have downloaded the app, then you might have seen that I had shared multiple posts on semiconductors. This industry was not going up. Actually, this week it came down a little bit. If we had profitable long positions, we need to be cautious and put protective stop. Let's look at some of the QSight posts. We can access it from the computer also. We can go to categories, QSight 360 degree, and it is under USA. This was the post. All these related industries in the USA are rapidly losing steam. You will see the exact analysis that we are doing every day in our live trading. The one that we are using in market roundups, I use the same analysis for all the QSight posts, both for India and America market. Even if you are not trading the exact instrument, exact same instrument, it will still help follow a disciplined approach. When I posted it on January 9th, I noticed QEdge scores are coming down fast for semiconductor industries. There are multiple stocks in these industries that are overvalued. I could see that by drilling down QEdge. Therefore, I suggested you may check that out and put stop. This is how QEdge heat map looked at that time. You notice over 5 days period, it was still cyan when I first posted it. However, the acceleration columns gave away. Deceleration in this case, magenta color, showing that it is quickly losing steam. We are not supposed to take any short trade until the 5 days turns magenta. However, we must be cautious about holding any long position and use protective stop. And 3 days ago, I followed up, and by then, you see, by then, there is more magenta color over 5 days period, and now deceleration is magenta over 5 days period as well. So how it will show up first is deceleration magenta over 1 day period, then it will show up over 2 days, and if the weakness continues, it will show up over the 5 days period. This is how the actual scores were. We can see semiconductor equipment was still cyan, and the other two semiconductor industries were turning magenta over 5 days as well. Let's now use the live system to see if it deteriorated further. Try to keep this snapshot in your mind. Let's go to industry analysis. Okay, let's start with sector analysis. In sector analysis, few of them like consumer discretionary energy are strong for quite long. They are maintaining their strength over 5 days, 2 days, 1 day period. Information technology, on the other hand, was the best performer, no doubt, 11, 11, 11, 11 or some tens across many months, but slowly weakening. And if we drill down to the industries, instantly you see the semiconductors catch our eye very fast. All of them are weak, even over 5 days period. Remember the last snapshot we kept in mind? Over 5 days period, the score was not magenta yet in the second post in Q site. But now, as of Friday's close, even 5 days period score has turned magenta. And pace score is clearly magenta. This gradual transition from strength to weakness is very visible in QH, and I believe very difficult to get somewhere else. That helps us not only take the exact turning point like we could do in department stores, marine industries, alternative carriers, but it also helps us decide when to protect profit, when not to start taking new buy positions in industries. And from the data, it seems semiconductor is one industry where we may refrain from taking long stocks, new long positions, and actually be cautious about holding new positions. These heat maps are pretty useful, isn't it? Let's summarize. Overall, the market is clearly bullish. In fact, I checked between SPY, QQQ, DIA and IWM, the four broad market ETFs, all of them went up by between 2.8 to almost, I think, 3.5 or 4% in last 2 weeks. That is very large gain considering that all of them were at or near all-time high. It was very bullish in the first week of the year and it got even stronger this week. The industries that were strong earlier are in general remaining strong. Semiconductor may be one exception that actually declined. All the three semiconductor industries actually turned negative this week. But in general, all the strong industries are remaining strong. Weaks are remaining weak, like real estate. This fact is also showing up in market breadth, where new high lows is strengthening faster than the other internals. As the market is bullish and the strong industries, strong stocks are continuing to be strong, there is no need to exit any profitable position. The industries and stocks that were languishing, they continue to languish, too late to take shorts, and there is not many good long opportunities you may find. So we may patiently wait for that turning point. That is all that I plan to share in today's session. Thanks a lot for joining me. I look forward to seeing you in our next session. Have a great weekend and trade profitably.